This basic OpenStreetMap tutorial is brought to you by HOT, the Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team. If you want to find out more about HOT, go to hotosm.org. So let's get started. In your browser, type tasks.hotosm.org. I will assume that you already have an OSM account, OpenStreetMap account, and that you have linked your account to the HotOSM Tasking Manager. If that is not the case, look at the footnotes of this video and I will put a link to a tutorial on how to create an account. So when you're in the Tasking Manager, you're presented with a number of tasks. Some of those tasks are for experienced mappers. For beginners, I recommend you go to task 1090. So type task 1090 here in the search bar, hit enter, and you're going to be presented with this screen. Again, select task 1090, and now we're coming to the description and the instructions linked to the task. It is important to read the description. The author in this case is the Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team. The requesting organization is Nepal and the International Response Community. The imagery that we're going to use is coming from Bing and Mapbox. Also, for beginners, there are some useful links towards tutorials provided by MapGive and LearnOSM. Now, let's have a look at the instructions. There again, some very useful information and a tagging guide for roads, buildings, and waterways. Now, for roads, you know the roads in Nepal are different than the roads that you might be used to. You have a link here, Nepal Roads page on the wiki, which is quite useful. But we're going to go through that in a second. At the bottom of the instructions, you'll see a note for validators. If you're a beginner, I wouldn't go there. Now, let's start contributing. Here in the contribute screen, we have the possibility to either take a task at random or select a task in the right side of the screen in the tiles which have been mapped for us. So what's important to notice is that those tiles are color-coded. They're high priority mapping tiles here in pink. They're tiles which have been validated in green, and we have a few here on this chart. There are tiles which have been mapped or qualified as done but not yet validated in orange, invalidated in gray, and those which are currently being worked on by other mappers and you don't have access to those tiles are circled in orange. So let me select a tile and I'll go, let me zoom in and select this one. Double click on it and I'll click start mapping. Here I have a choice to use different type of editors. If I click on this arrow, you'll see a number of different editors. For beginners, it's really important to start with the ID editor. So this is what I'm going to do. Select ID editor, and immediately a new window opens. So you're presented with this window and tools on the right side of your screen. Plus will help you zoom in. Minus will help you zoom out. By the way, if you use the wheel of your mouse, you can also zoom in and zoom out using the wheel of your mouse. The third icon shows my location, and this one, let's click on it, and it will allow me to look at different brightness of the image. In this case, I'm going to select 100% brightness, and you see how the image has come a little bit clearer. I'm going to leave the selection of the Bing aerial imagery and click again on the icon. Another one that's useful, another tool, is the bottom one. This will provide you more information about the different tasks that we can do during our mapping exercise. There's also a very useful walkthrough that you can click on. So we're not going to do that now. I'm going to navigate through my tile and focus on this area. I'm going to zoom in with the wheel of my mouse and look at what we have here. So some mappers have already started mapping this area. So let's click on this orange line, and on the left side of the screen I can see that this was defined as a secondary road. Let's look at this yellow area. I'm going to click on the edge of the area and look at the left side of the screen. This is a residential area. Okay, I'm going to click outside of the area which I have selected, and with the wheel of my mouse, I'm going to zoom in. So here are some buildings which have been mapped. Now, this yellow border is kind of inhibiting me to see all the buildings. So what I'm going to do is click here on the right side on this tool, and then click on fill areas and show no fill. Okay, so now I have a better view of all those buildings. Let's pick a building, and I'm going to select area and start mapping a building. So here are two buildings which I'd like to start mapping. I'm going to left click and carefully follow the edges of the building. If I'm not sure, I can zoom in with the wheel of my mouse. I'm going to click again, and click again, and double click to finish. Now I need to tell OSM that this is a building. So I'm going to select this area and go to the left side of my screen, click on building, scroll down, and select building. I recommend you only select building. Do not select any other selection at this time. Select building, and now that is qualified as a building in OpenStreetMap. There's another task that I need to do here, is to square my building. Buildings are square or rectangle, and here I have an icon on the right side. I will let you discover the other icons and what they help you do, but in this case I want to square the corner of my area. And here it is. It is now squared. I want to map this other building, so I'm going to zoom in, select area, and carefully map the edges of this other building without touching the first building which I have mapped. This is very important. So I go to the edges here, then I'm going to go up a bit, double click to finish, select building on the left side of my screen. Now that's a building. I'm going to go back to my area, left click on it, and square it. If I zoom in, I see that those two, I'm going to click outside of my area, those two are not connected, and that's exactly what I want. Okay, I'm going to zoom back out, and I want to look at the area that has been mapped by a previous mapper. Let me click on it to select it. I see some houses outside of this residential area. So I'm going to take this dot and bring it out a little bit so that I have my residential area that goes around those buildings. Let's map another residential area. Let me move up a bit. And I see some houses here. So I'm going to select area and then draw an area around the houses that represents a residential area. So now I have my area design. Let me go to the left side of the screen, select land use, and then residential area. That's it. That is now a residential area. So we need to map buildings, square them, not connect them together, and we need to map residential areas. Another thing that we need to do is to map roads. So I see a road here that connects to another road, and this looks to me as a residential road because it is connected to a residential area. So I'm going to click on line and then start following this road all the way to the main road. Double click to finish. Go on the left side of my screen on roads, and I'm going to select residential road. That's it. That is now a residential road. Now it is connected, as I can see, to what looks to be a main road. So I'm going to click line, and I won't cover all of the road, but let me start here just for the purpose of this tutorial. I need to connect the two, residential road and the main road. That's very important. And then I'm going to follow it down a little bit. Let me move my map so that I can continue my mapping exercise to go down. And I'm going to again continue. Let me move my map up a bit all the way to, well, about here. Double click to finish. Road. And now what I'm going to do is to not select residential road because I think this is a main road. I'm going to scroll down all the way to unknown roads. And that is an unknown road. Other mappers will be able to come in and put more information, but for now, just select unknown road. Okay, I see what looks to be a track that goes here in the woods. So I'm going to select line and connect the road which I've just mapped to what I'm going to qualify as a map. So let me go up in the woods a little bit. I'm going to move my map all the way to here. Double click to finish. And then I'm going to go to roads, scroll down, and select track. If you're not sure, you can actually click on I, and that will give you a picture. Obviously, this is not a Nepal picture, but it gives you an impression of, or a feeling of what a track looks like. So I'm going to click track, and if it was on a bridge, I would click bridge here, but obviously this is not, so I'm just going to leave it as is. And now this is a track, which is connected to a road. Now here I see what looks to be a pedestrian path. And actually it is called a path in OpenStreetMap. So let's select line, connect it to my track, and follow that path in the middle of the woods. You know, if a path is in a mountain, I'm going to double click to finish. If a path is in the mountain, you'll see some zigzags. And that's typically a good indication that this is a path. So let's go on the left side of my screen, select path, and this is a footpath. Click on a footpath, and there again, if it was a bridge, I would click bridge here, but obviously this is not, so I'm just going to leave it as footpath and click on footpath again. All right, so we've learned how to map buildings, residential areas. If you recall, residential road, a road, scroll down, a path, I'm sorry, tracks and a path, and they're all interconnected. That's really important because people on the ground will be using those network of roads, path, and tracks to navigate. Okay, to finish up, I need to hit save, and then left side of my screen to hit save again. Do not forget that in order for other mappers to be able to come into this tile, you have to go back to the tasking manager and click unlock. That's it. You're done. I hope this was useful, and I wish you a lot of fun in mapping your task.